Hello viewers, welcome to Elim TV, a station where you watch, interact and also learn. Your tutor today is Mr. Wanyoike, a mathematics teacher. In today's lesson, we're in Form 4, Lesson 1, and the topic is matrices and transformation, and the subtopic is multiplication of a matrix. I'm going to start with multiplication, although you were taught in Form 3, and it is a recap of what happened in Form 3. And the object, the lesson objectives, by the end of this lesson, you should be able to multiply a matrix of order 2 by 2, two matrix of order 2 by 2. For example, I have an example here. Given that the matrix of A is given as I read the rows, the number which are contained in the row, we have 2, 4, and in the second row we have 5, 6. And the matrix B, in the first row we have negative 1, 2, and in the second row we have 0 and 3. And you are supposed to find A and B. And therefore, you are supposed to multiply the matrix of A, you multiply with the matrix of B. As you can see here, the matrix of A here is represented here. And the matrix of B, it is also well represented here. And in Form 3, you were taught that a matrix is a grouping of numbers in terms of rows and columns, and the numbers are enclosed using a bracket. And therefore, we are going to multiply matrix of A, you multiply by matrix of B, and therefore you are supposed to get the product of A and B. And what are you supposed to do? In the first matrix, the first matrix is of order 2 by 2, meaning that there are two rows and also there are two columns. Also, in the second matrix B, we have two rows. This is the row number 1 and this is row number 2. And therefore, the order of this matrix B is also 2 by 2 because it is having two rows and also it is having two columns. And therefore, the order of this matrix is a 2 by 2 matrix. And what you are supposed to do, the row, I am going to give you a formula which will be helping you whenever it comes to matrix. Whenever you are multiplying any two matrix, you are supposed to use the row in the first matrix. That is, you can always be saying Roman Catholic. Roman Catholic, the first Roman stand for the first matrix. You work with the row, and the Catholic, that is in the second matrix, you are supposed to use the column. And therefore, in this, whenever you're multiplying these two matrix, you're supposed to say 2 in the first column, in the first matrix, that is 2. Then you multiply that 2 by negative 1 in the second matrix, and you can see it is well illustrated here, and the answer, you will get it as negative 2. It is also well written here. Then you continue you continue with the matrix of A, that is the second number, it should be 4. Then you multiply by 0, because as far as the first matrix is concerned, you're supposed to use the row, and as far as the second matrix is concerned, you're supposed to use the first column. And in this case, you will get 4. You multiply by 0 and the answer becomes 0. And you can see the answer becomes negative 2 plus 0. Then you go to the second column in this second in the second matrix, that is matrix B. You repeat again with the top number, the numbers, that is 2. You multiply by 2. Then you will get it as 4. You can see it is well written here. Then you multiply 4. You multiply by 3 in the second column, and you will end up getting 12. So 4 plus 12, that is the answer. Then you go to the second row. As far as the first matrix is concerned, you say 5. You multiply by negative 1. You can say I've written it here. Then you take 6, then you multiply by 0. You can see it is well written there. Then you take the second column in the second matrix. Then you multiply by the second row of the first matrix, that is 5. Then you multiply 5, you multiply by 2. You can see it is well written here. And also 6, you multiply by 5, you can see it is also well written here. And after adding them, you will get 5 times 2, you get 10, and 6 times 3, you will get it as 18. And 5 times minus 1, you will get minus 5, and 6 times 0, you will get 0. And therefore, once you add negative 2 plus 0, you will get negative 2, and 4 plus 12, you will get 16, and 5 plus 0, you get negative 5, and 10 plus 18, you will get 28. And therefore, the product of AB becomes negative 2. I read the first row, negative 2, and the second number in the first row is at 16. And the second row of the answer is supposed to be negative 5, and the second number in that row should be 28, and that is our answer. We have come to the end of today's lesson, and I'm going to give you the following question as an assignment. Given that matrix A is given as negative 2, 4, that is the first row, and the second row 1, 0, and matrix of B is given as 1, I'm reading the first row, 1, 2, and 3, and the second row is 4, 2, and 1, 4, 2, and 1. Then you are asked find the product of matrix A and B. So you are supposed to use exactly the procedure which I have already illustrated in this lesson for you to get a correct answer. For reference, you can refer from secondary mathematics, student book 2, and the student book 4, and the publisher is the Kenya Literature Bureau. For more information, you can reach us at using the following addresses, using SMS. The number is well displayed for you. You can also use YouTube. You can use a Facebook platform at Elim TV. And finally, you can use Twitter at @ElimTV_KE. Thank you for joining me in this lesson. Till next lesson, bye-bye.